up, my geeks and freaks? Big Girl Geek here with a brand new review. And today I am here to review Young Justice Outsiders, Season 3, Episode 13, Influence. Y'all know what time it is. It's time for the geek out. Oh my God, it feels like it's been years since we've been on this channel talking about Young Justice Outsiders. And I know usually in the past, I've done all the episodes that have released in one video, but so far I've only been able to see episode 13, and I wanted to get this video out while it's fresh on my mind. And going forward, my goal is to, you know, do it how I did before and do all three episodes in one video to not, like, you know, drag it out. That's my goal. But so much is going on, like, you know, Spider-Man, and then Stranger Things just got released. Happy 4th of July, by the way, if you're catching this on Independence Day. Hope you're enjoying your day off, and I hope you're having a fabulous summer. So much going on this summer, and I'm hoping that my plan stays intact and I get to do all three or four episodes in one video. So, quick housekeeping. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Or if you've been riding with me this whole time, thanks for riding with me. But if you are new, I ask simply that you hit that subscribe button if you are liking what I'm putting out. You can also give this video a thumbs up. Leave a comment. Would love to talk with you. Talking with other comic book fans is like my kink. I love it. So yes, if you're enjoying this channel, if you're enjoying the videos and you haven't yet subscribed, or you're brand new and you love this right off the bat, please hit that subscribe button. I have a goal to hopefully by the end of this month get to 350 subscribers. I'm a small channel just tugging through this giant thing we call YouTube. All right. So now that's out the way, let's get to the juicy good stuff and talk about my favorite animated show out right now, Young Justice. When it comes to animation, DC is superior. I don't know why they can't get their movies or some of their TV shows on the CW together and get that right, but they are by far like on top. For me, when it comes to animation, I love DC animation. I was always a Marvel girl growing up, but they are like, the animation is like rising, and I've found myself becoming more involved with these DC characters and reading more books and learning more history and backstory of some of these iconic DC characters. And before, you could never catch me in a Batman shirt, and here I am just like all over it. So the episode picked up right where the previous episode left off. And I didn't even feel like I needed to go back and watch the 12 episodes before this premiered. I know they changed the date. It used to be Fridays that it was released. I believe now it's new every Tuesday. So that kind of threw me off too. I was like thinking it was coming out tomorrow. And then I'm looking, I'm like, why is everybody talking about Outsiders? What the heck, is out already? So that threw me off. You know, we had to get through a season of Doom Patrol before we could come back to this amazing story that I've been, feel like I've been waiting for forever to come back. So, which I know, I never finished Doom Patrol. I guess I fell off. I guess it really wasn't holding my interest as much as I thought. I finished off on, like, episode 8. Let me know if Doom Patrol is really worth finishing the whole season. And I didn't even start Swamp Thing because it was canceled. So let me know what you guys think. I'm just waiting for Titans and Young Justice at this point. So, let's see. Influence. You see our group of young superheroes. Well, actually, the episode starts off with our OG characters. Hawkwoman, Hawkman, Superman, we have a new Green Lantern named Guy. I'm not familiar with that Green Lantern. I mostly know, you know, John, and I don't know who Guy is. He's in the comics as a Green Lantern, or is this new for the show? Can somebody please enlighten this girl here? Who else was with them? Wonder Woman, my girl, and they are on, Thanagar, meeting with a Tau general, giving him an update on everything that's happened with the, what they found out with the mind control and what's going on with that, about the young metahumans, the children that are being kidnapped by Granny Goodness through the goggles. They're just like briefing. He's not really here for it because when Hawkman and Hawkwoman in last season got mind controlled, he had to clean that mess up, and he's just not here for their foolishness. He considers them humans, even though we all know that Superman is a Kryptonian and not a human, and Wonder Woman is a half goddess, so you know what I mean. So once they leave that situation, we do get to see the young heroes, and we see Tara, who is undercover and actually working for the shadow people, the League of Shadows. Yes, she's undercover. She's been brainwashed. They're following that story with her and Wilson. And we see her, we see Forger, we see, maybe I did need a refresher course because I'm just like starting to forget their names already. Halo, we see them all becoming part. Cyborg, we see them all becoming part of the team. I'm trying to remember who else was there because we also see Garth come back and he joins the team. They have like this little induction and they tell them Nightwing, Superboy, and Huntress. She's still Huntress, right? Telling them, no, she's not Huntress. Didn't she changed her name? Didn't she change her name? I guess I did need a refresher course. At first when I was watching, I felt like I got right back into it. But then I'm like thinking, I'm like, oh shoot, what did happen? Because she didn't want to be, after Wally died, she wanted to be someone else. We're all seeing them induct them, along with Miss Martian, into the team. We don't get to see the other team members yet, like the new Kid Flash and all that, and they're telling their stories about how some of them left and how they decided to come back. So they all officially become team members except Cyborg. He's just not there yet. He's not ready. We see Wolf a little bit. This was a lot of talking and I guess catching up and not a lot of action. So there were no fights between the bad guy and the good guy except towards the end of the episode. So, I mean, this kind of got you like a refresher course very quickly. Like, these are the goggles. This is what happened with the goggles. Granny Goodness is bad. Lex Luthor has put Sister Lena Luthor in charge. Now, I said this before because we're seeing Black Lightning, who was in this for a brief moment. His story, he's divorced with Jen, with his wife, and now he's kind of having a relationship with his doctor. And we see sort of that on the Black Lightning TV show, where when it first started in the first season, they were like separated. Now, did they bring Black Lightning in because of that popularity on the show, the TV show? So I'm wondering, did they bring Lena Luthor in because of her popularity on Supergirl? So I thought that was, I was like, okay. We see, I don't, you know what I'm saying? Like, all of a sudden Lena Luthor popped up. I don't remember her being mentioned in previous seasons, but now that she's like a regular on Supergirl, I wonder if that's why they brought her into this. Now, so the episode for me, was good. I was just happy to see those characters again. But like I said, it wasn't a lot of action. We got to see Barda, Big Barda. I think this was the first time we've seen her. So it was great to see her and the Furies. And we see them fighting Superman, Wonder Woman, and Hawk Woman. And Superman saves Big Barda. So now she's like, oh, wow, my God, you saved me. So that's probably going to jump into the storyline, how, you know, Big Barda switched sides. She works with Granny Goodness, but then she ends up coming over and working for the good guys and being a part of the Justice League. So that was like a slight hint into maybe they're going to do that story with the remainder of the season. Big Barda like slowly probably switching sides. I won't say she just won't jump. I don't know. I haven't seen the other two episodes. Maybe you have. Just jump in and be like, oh, she switched sides just because Superman saved her from being tortured from Granny Goodness. But I don't know. I can't see it happening just like that. I hope it's not rushed. I hope it's like a slow burn into her switching sides and joining the Justice League. So it was great to see, you know, Halo relationship. They threw a little scene in there to kind of go with the times where she's not he or she. She doesn't know what she is, and that goes along with what we see in the LGBTQ plus community now, where, you know, there are certain people that feel like they don't use he or she, they don't use pronouns. It's those pronouns, they, them, you know. So she doesn't know what she is now because she's a mother box. So I mean, I get what they were trying to do, and it also ties in with the story because to her, like, even though she looks like a girl, she just doesn't know what she is yet because she died and now she's a mother box. So I get it. I didn't have any problem with that. I don't know, some people will, because, you know, a lot of people are like, you know, stop throwing this stuff in my face. And, see the previous video of them casting a black mermaid. So people, I know, don't like that whole situation. Some people, like I said, I don't mind it. I don't think it's a political agenda. I hope nobody else feels that way. I thought it fit with the story. Let me know what you thought about that. So, yeah, I mean, like I said, it really wasn't too much going on in this episode, except some, like, little nuggets of, we got to see, like I said, some new characters. We got Garth returning to the team. We got these them becoming official team members. I'm so shocked that they just let Tara in willy-nilly because that's his sister, but Brion's sister, but they, like, really didn't do any back-checking. I don't remember if, like, Megan, Miss Martian even, like, read her thoughts or, you know, read her mind. So that was very weird. I think that they should know they've been messed over before. But what did you guys think of the episode overall? I give it a B because I'm just happy it's back, even though it didn't have a lot of action toward it unless the last few seconds of the episode. But I'm just so excited the show is back. I love the show. It's my favorite animated show. It's killing it. It's killing some of the regular shows on the CW, like Arrow, Flash. It's killing it story-wise, action-wise. I'm loving it. What'd you guys think? Can't wait to discuss with you. Please leave a comment, as always. And until next video, I'm out of here. Big girl geek out. Peace.
Hey, where are you going? You just watched a cool video. Subscribe.